Good morning. It's Alea. I have a new microphone, so I guess we shall see how well this does. And I am trying to put in a really quick video. I just opened the gallery, and of course, as soon as I turn on the camera, people start to walk in the door. I can sit in here all day and nobody walks in, but if I turn on the camera, people walk in. So anyway, just an update on what's going on with me and what's going on with the training. I did do raw all day yesterday. This getting back into the swing after having gotten out of it for the month of February is more challenging than I expected it to be. And part of that actually seems to be psychological. Well, probably all of it's psychological, but a lot of it seems to be psychological in that in March, it seemed like I was getting back on track pretty good, you know? And then when the end of March hit, like the mid to the end of March, and I actually saw the results of the goofing off that I did in February, because it doesn't hit until like 30 days later. And so when I saw what had happened to my body because I had slowed down in February, then I got really discouraged. And so it's been difficult for me to, you know, to get the momentum back. But I tell you, nothing helps you get the momentum back like not feeling good. Ha ha. And so I developed some kind of a weird little, I don't know, low-grade infection or inflammation or something that had me just feeling sleepy and tired and run down and just blah. And the tendency is to eat something cooked. It's like, you know, I don't know, feed a cold, starve it, whatever the heck it is. I kept thinking, oh, I need to eat something. I need to eat something. And so I went and got food that had worked, or I guess it didn't even work then, but I thought it worked when I was little. So, you know, I got steamed vegetables. I got rice. I almost got chicken soup. I didn't, but I almost did. I did broth. I was trying to do all these things that were foods from my youth that in the past I thought had made me feel better when I didn't feel good. And none of it worked. None of it worked. I just continued to feel worse and worse and worse. And I kept having to pop more and more pills. They were herbal pills, echinacea and astragalus, but they were still pills. And I mean, I was eating the things like candy, and it was basically just keeping it at bay. It was not fixing it. And on Saturday, I finally, it hit me. It's like, wait a minute, what do you do when you have inflammation? I had it before. And what did I do? Oh, I went raw. And so, you know, I just hit the kitchen and I just juiced. I mean, I juiced like crazy. I did a great big jar of green juice and no cooked food. I did fruit and then slept and took my herbs. And within a day, it started to turn. But this whole thing of seeing results on the body is a big deal, because when I was seeing results, now mind you, it took me like 6 months of lifting weights, light weights, but lifting, and, you know, training every day and eating really clean and all of that in order to see any definition in my body at all that I could see. Other people were going, oh, you're losing weight. I wasn't seeing anything. So in order for me to see anything at all, it took almost 6 months. Then when I started goofing off, I didn't see any difference, you know, because I guess I was riding on the wave of the good stuff that I had done. So the bad stuff didn't show up until like 30 days later. And I swear to God, it showed up in a bang. And something in my head says, oh, if you're eating good, then it's going to show up right away. If you're eating bad, it's going to show up right away. It doesn't. It does not. So, you know, you look like you're sailing along and you're doing okay. You know, you have that little slice of cake and you have an avocado and, you know, you do the raw vegan ice cream and then you do some nut butter and it's like, oh, I'm doing fine. I'm eating this stuff. And then all of a sudden, you know, and then you have steamed vegetables and then you have rice and then you have sushi. And it's like, well, it's all still really good food and I'm eating low fat, but like a month later, you happen to look down and you're going, what the heck happened? Where did that come from? And so I'm having to kind of like back up and go, wait, what did I do? How did it work? Okay, let me do that in order to get myself back on track. And I will offer this to you guys. One thing that is encouraging, I had some clothes that were way, way, way too small for me, but I really loved them. I had a silk jogging suit that I just like, oh my God, I love this. I couldn't even get my fat butt in it. You know, it was like, my butt was way too wide to get in it. But I kept it because it was so pretty, the color was pretty, and I absolutely loved it, and so I didn't get rid of it. Well, when I lost all the weight, 65 pounds, yes, when I lost all the weight, I didn't even think about it, and as I tossed out all the clothes and I'm going through the guest room, all of a sudden I found this jogging suit, two of them actually, and I was like, oh, I wonder if these fit now. Now, mind you, I'm doing this whole little dance about, you know, having gained some weight after having lost weight, blah, 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 and it was so nice to try on that silk jogging suit, and it literally slid right off my body. It just fell off. And there was a time, not that long ago, about a year ago, that I couldn't get those pants on. So I know that it works. I know that it's working. And today I'm raw again. I did cauliflower rice, which was delicious yesterday. That was what I ate along with my green juice and fruit. Today I have cauliflower rice again. I have fruit, I have green juice, and that'll be my meals for today, except for the coffee that I had this morning. And I like coffee, so I'm drinking it. And you know, denial to me is bad. I really feel that if you are going to shift something, you have to stop because you want to, not because you have to, and not because you're making yourself stop. It has to just be a natural progression. And coffee has not gone away yet in my world, so it's still there, so I drink it. If I see it and I decide I want it, I have it. If I don't want it, then I don't have it. Anyway, that's my update. I hope this has been informative for you, if not helpful. So get that outfit that doesn't fit and just tuck it away somewhere, and you'll eventually fit into it. And then if you fall off the wagon, go put that outfit on and see that, oh my God, it fits. That's right, I lost this much weight. And it really does sort of bolster you to keep going. And do know that it's not going to show up for at least 6 or 8 weeks. You're not going to see any results really that's noticeable for about 6 or 8 weeks, and then all of a sudden it just hits you and you're going, whoa, I've got definition, whoa, I've got more energy, you know, and all the things that make it work for you. So the other thing that I want to tell you is, if you are doing any kind of detox, make sure that you take the time to let your body detox gently. Don't like slam yourself with Senna and, you know, all the really heavy duty detox stuff. Do gentle detox. Do, you know, things that just kind of work your body easily, because I don't know about you guys, but I don't do anything over the top. you know, when I went to train for the marathon, it was slow. It was 5K and then a 10K and then a half and then a full marathon. When I went to eat raw, it was, you know, eating more raw than cooked, and then, you know, until I got to almost 100% raw. So I guess the operative thing is be gentle with yourself. And if you fall off the wagon, tomorrow's another day. I hope this has been helpful, and I will talk to you later. Have a fabulous day. Aloha!